Hi guys, welcome back to another MD video. My name is Michael and today I'm going to be giving you step-by-step instructions on how to replace the battery on your BMW R9t. I hope this helps you out, so stick around. Okay, so let's see what we need to do. Firstly, we have to take off the back seat. There's an Allen key bolt right up here. It's going to remove the back seat. Then we can take off the front seat. We also will have to remove these decorative pieces on the sides. There's a bolt over here, and I think there's two under the seat that we're going to have to take them off because we need to remove the tank as well. And you can't lift the tank with these on. There's bolts that hold the tank on right over here. And then when we got the tank off, there's a bracket that holds the battery in underneath here, and we will be able to remove the battery finally. So let's try and get into it. Okay, here you can see the bolts that are holding on these pieces. So we're going to remove these bolts, take this part off, and as you can see there's this black plate which is part of the tank which goes in underneath, which is on top of the battery. So once we have these removed and get the tank removed, we should be able to get to the battery below it. Okay, so I've removed all the bolts, the ones that hold the tank on, the ones at the back, the with the aesthetic plates on the side, and I think I've had a look. I can't lift the tank just yet. It looks like I'm gonna have to take these off on the side, and then there's where the intake is on the other side. It's got two bolts as well, which I'm gonna take off to take the side covers off to see if there's anything holding the tank down on the side, and then hopefully we can lift the tank. Okay, so it's only necessary to loosen this part so that this little tab clears the bottom of the intake tube over here. And then on the other side of the bike, you need to click out this little thing over here. And so it's loose so you can lift up the tank and just check if there's any wires underneath here. But I think this is the only thing that's caught on this tab over here that you need to disconnect. So the intake itself, the cover is only held on with this rubber grommet that's right up in there just behind it, so you can just pull it forward and it should come right off. Okay, so the tank is loose. We can now lift it up and disconnect the fuel lines. They are quick release from what I know, so it should be quite simple. I am gonna put a rag in there just for extra spillage, and then I'm going to try and film it as much as I can, but we're going to prop it up and get the fuel lines disconnected and see if we can get this thing to lift over. So I've just placed a piece of wood on the inside. It's on the air box and it's just lifting up the tank from the bottom. It's a bit difficult to use one hand to get in here. There's also two connectors, two little plugs that you need to disconnect over here. It's going to be easy if you have two people doing this. But with one person, if you've got a piece of wood just to lift the tank and hold it for you, you can get to those plugs with both hands. So there actually is this stopper over here, which goes over this little roller side over here. It just popped off now when I pushed the tank back, but it does fit over there and it prevents the tank from tipping back because it latches over here. But if you pull it off and you take it to the middle, this gives you a lot more freedom with the tank coming backwards, and you can almost get the tank straight up so you can get to the battery which is underneath. So finally we can see the battery. There it is. and there's a bracket holding it, so we gotta disconnect that, then disconnect positive, then the negative. Gotta remove some of this cable ties over here so we can get this loom out of the way, and we should be able to lift the battery out finally. Also just place the board, the plank, the back here, so the tank leans on it, so it doesn't put all that stress on the plastic little stopper. It might break, so let's try and get this battery out.
So there we go, quite the mission. The battery is out finally, and we can take it to the local bike shop now, get a replacement unit for it. We're not taking it to BMW to get a OEM BMW battery, because that's gonna be extremely expensive. It's also why we're doing this ourselves, because taking it into the BMW specialist shop is gonna be so expensive, and it's a lot easier and cheaper doing it, well, not easier, but cheaper doing it yourself. So let's get that battery replaced and get the new one in. Okay, it is the next day and I'm quickly heading out to the bike shop to go pick up the battery for the R9T. So let's go. For you, it's gonna be instant. Check it out. Oh, whoa, that was quick and easy.
Okay, new battery is in. Negative to negative, positive to positive. Now we have to reverse the process. Start by putting the bracket that holds the battery back, then putting down the tank, putting back the plugs, putting back the fuel lines, making sure that everything is nice and sorted, and then we'll turn the key and see if the bike runs, and then we'll bolt down the tank and put all the panels back and make sure everything's nice and neat. Before we hook up the fuel lines and reattach the plugs underneath the tank, remember we have to put this little plastic clip back over that side of the tank. Cool, fuel lines are on, plugs are on. Everything's correct. Let's put in the key and see if we have power. Beautiful.
Okay, so now it's pretty much a process of working backwards and putting all these parts back on the bike the same way it came off. So we'll start with the intake panel, and then we will start with the decorative side pieces that go onto the back. And then we can put the seats back on, and that should be pretty much everything, and make sure everything's nice and tight, and then we'll fire up and see if everything works.
And also remember to put this little thing, clip it back into its little spot underneath there. There we go.
Everything is tight, everything is looking good. I'm gonna see now if she turns over, so let's turn this thing on and see if it works. Whoa, just a second before we fire up this bad boy. If you haven't already, please consider liking and subscribing to the channel. And if you feel like helping out the MD channel, check the donation link in the description down below. With that being said, let's get back to it. Okay, success, she works, she starts. I think the battery has, the one I just put in has stood for just a little bit, so it just needs to run through, get a little bit more of a charge on it, and it should run perfectly, but It is a heavy engine to turn over. I think that's why it took just a few more seconds just to get it going. But I think it's gonna work, and that's how you replace the battery. So I think that's gonna do it. See you back at the studio. There it is, guys, we are done. I hope this video helped you out. If you want to replace the battery on your BMW R9T and you don't want to take it to the dealership so that they can do it, and you want to do it yourself, I hope this video helped you out. My name is Michael, and as always, I hope you enjoy this video. Until next time, I will see you on the next one. See ya.